trend with synergistic effects on scale economies is that of a farther determinant called experience and learning economies, according to which average cost per unit drops when the cumulative volume produced by a company throughout its history increase. This was empirically proven as it is a result of the experience and learning effect acquired by operators who are increasingly able to improve the efficiency of processes developed thanks to a growingly increased comprehension, repetition, and rationalization. Experience economies have a dynamic origin linked to irreversibility and timing. The first movers in a market can have a cost advantage linked to the only fact that they have accumulated production over time, and therefore they acquired more experience on the activity connected to it, compared to competitors who entered the market later. The positive effect of experience and learning on cost differentials can be defended if the experience is shared inside the company, but tacit outside of it. Learning has to be collected among employees and managers, but the company shouldn't hire suppliers or consultants to formalize the experience and reuse it in its activities. On the contrary, the learning effect is weak in case of relevant changes in context and radical innovations introduced by competitors or by new entrants, which substantially disrupt the way the activity is carried out and reset the curve of experience, thus forcing all players to start from zero and acquire experience in the new process. Localization of activities is also a possible cause determinant, as it has effect on a series of elements such as supply and transportation cost, and it is affected by the choice's timing. Whenever localization is strategically relevant and there is a natural or regulatory limit to the maximum number of actors entering the most favorable markets, localization becomes a significant source of competitive advantage, as well as a barrier to new entrants. Preferential access to distribution channels is partly linked to the topic of localization and considers how the actual access to distribution channels can determine outbound logistic cost of competitors. For instance, competitors can bear different costs to access existing channels or set up their own proprietary channels. Costs can also be determined by institutional factors. In some industries, public administration and authorities define which and how many actors can compete in the market, for instance, by providing specific licenses. They approve regulations, for instance, environmental regulations. They establish duties, incentives, and disincentives. When the role of public institutions is key, a company's or a company's group's political ability to obtain government contracts and state aid through activities traditionally called lobbying or advocacy can be a source of competitive differentials from an internal point of view, or an entry barrier from an external point of view. As a whole, the full list of cost drivers I discussed should be assessed to determine the origins of a company's cost competitive advantage or disadvantage compared to its rivals.